Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. So this is the beginning of a new week. Why don't we start our week with something valuable, with a statement that can be of value for us? So let's just read out this statement. Caring for our seniors is perhaps the greatest responsibility we have. Absolutely true. Those who walked before us have given us so much and made possible the life we all enjoy. So this is the very true statement and very heart-touching statement, because we often do not realize what our elders have done for us. Not only the family members, but elders in general are the respected population that we should all respect. So in that regard only, the government of India has also taken a step. What is that step? The step is to release the quality of life index for the elderly population, so that the elderly population's life and their situation can be assessed through that index. Isn't it interesting? So in this video, we are going to discuss that index in detail. Apart from that index, we are also going to discuss a lot of questions that can be of use for your upcoming NABARD examination. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and the questions that I take in this video are going to be useful for your RBI, SEBI, NABARD and banking PO examinations. So let's quickly discuss the index and the questions, because I know that you all are eager to know the questions. So guys, before moving on to the questions, if you haven't subscribed our channel, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification, because you will get the instant updates by doing that. And this is the Telegram group which you can join if you want to get the PDF of this session. So here is the very index that I was talking about. So quality of life for elderly people. Which state has topped in the aged states category of quality of life for elderly index 2021? So guys, first of all, this index is released by the Economic Advisory Council of the Government of India, which is chaired by Vivek Deberoy. So this council has released this index, which assesses the situation of elderly people across India. And in this index has divided the states in four categories. And out of those four categories, this is one category, aged states category. So what is assessed in this category? The states which have more than 5 million elderly population. Now elderly means people who are aged 60 plus. Okay, so this is the benchmark age for classifying the people as elderly in India. Now which state has topped in this category? It is Rajasthan. So Rajasthan has more than 5 million elderly population. Now let us understand this index in detail, because this can be of use for your GA part, for your ESI part. Okay, not only in phase 1 but in phase 2 as well. So let's look at this index in detail. The first point we have already discussed. The second point is that this institution has prepared this index on the request of Economic Advisory Council. National Elderly Policy declared 60 plus as the elderly population. The purpose of launching this index is to identify the regional patterns of aging across Indian states and assess the overall aging situation in India. Why do we need to do that? That is mentioned in this statement, but let's just first read out this statement. The index broadens the way we understand the needs and opportunities of the elderly population in India. Why do we need to understand the elderly population? One reason is, of course, the code that I mentioned in the beginning itself, but there is a huge economic reason behind this as well. So that reason is that the share of elderly people as a percentage of total population in the country is expected to increase from 7.5% in 2001 to 12.5% by 2026 to 19.5% in 2025. So this is the increment in the elderly population, and usually India is categorized as a young country, therefore the elderly population is often neglected. But due to this index, Now, the focus is being laid on the elderly population as well. So, guys, you need to memorize this statement. The proportion. This is very important statement from your exam point of view. Direct question can be made out of this statement. Okay, so here are the facts related to this index, which are very, very important. I'm continuously saying important because this index is useful for your ESI as well. Parameters. So this index assesses the situation of states in four parameters: financial well-being, social well-being, health system, and income security. Then it also has 8 sub-pillars: economic empowerment, educational attainment, employment, social status, physical security, basic health, psychological well-being, social security, and enabling environment. So these are the 8 sub-pillars of this index. Your responsibility is to memorize all of these 8 sub-pillars as well as 4 major pillars. Okay. Categories of states for ranking. Aged states means more than 5 million people are above the age of 60. A total of 10 states were ranked in this category. Relatively aged states. Population less than 5 million. So elderly population in states, elderly population less than 5%. Okay, so those states are categorized as relatively aged states. Total 10 states again were assessed in this category. Total Union Territory is 8. And remember that Dadar and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu were taken as separate Union Territories for assessment. Northeastern states, total 8, including Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh. Rankings pe dekh lete hain. So the top performers are Rajasthan in the aged states category that we have already seen, followed by the Maharashtra. Relatively aged states, Himachal Pradesh, then Uttarakhand. Union territories, Chandigarh, then Dadar and Nagar Haveli. Northeastern states, Mizoram, then Meghalaya. Rankings, worst performers. So basically, this is for the top rankers, this is for the bottom rankers. Aged states, Telangana. Relatively aged states, Gujarat. Union territory mein Jammu Kashmir is at the bottom. Northeastern states, Arunachal Pradesh. Guys, do remember that the ranking is based on the 4 pillars that we have discussed. 4 pillars and 8 sub-pillars. So this index, these rankings are not only indicating the population, but they are also assessing the overall dynamics of elderly people, the socio-economic dynamics, the socio-economic conditions in which the elderly people are living in different states of India. Okay. Pillar-wise score of India. So guys, this is the national average. Your responsibility is to memorize each of the scores. National average. Okay. So in the health system, 66.97 is the health, is the national average. That means this pillar is the best performer. All of the states, or we can say majority of the states in India, are performing really well in terms of health performance. Social well-being is the next best parameter. Financial well-being is the third best, 44.7, but a lot of work is to be done in this field. Now guys, I have a question for you. And my question is that recently a committee was formed in order to improve or suggest measures for setting up longevity finance hub within the IFSC. You have to tell that who is the chairperson of this committee that has been formed to suggest measures to IFSCA for setting up this longevity finance hub within IFSC that will cater to the needs, financial needs of the elderly population. Head of this committee. Okay. Moving further, income security is the worst performer. So this states that we do not pay, the government side does not pay much attention towards the income security of the elderly people. Strengthening the income of elderly people is not our priority according to this index. So there is one fact as well that we spend 1% of our GDP on pensions, which is relatively low. And this needs to be improved. Okay. Okay, so guys, that was all about this index. I hope that you have understood the index well and you will answer your question in the comment section below. So I hope that everything is clear here. I'm moving on to the next question. Which has become India's first cryptocurrency unicorn? So unicorns are those companies which have net worth of 1 billion. Which has become the first cryptocurrency company to be the unicorn? So it is CoinDCX. How much penalty will be levied on ATMs for not having cash for more than 10 hours a month? So you have the five options, out of which rupees 10,000 per ATM is the right answer. So guys, this penalty will be levied on the ATMs that are run by the banks and the white label ATMs. White label ATMs are those ATMs which are run by non-bank entities. Okay, different entities run the white label ATMs. So this penalty will be levied on the ATMs which are run by banks and these white label ATMs. Apart from this, there is nothing much. And remember that this penalty will start from October 1st, 2021. So this will be implemented from October 1st only. Which country is the chair of the Forum of the Election Management Bodies of South Asia for 2021 to 2022? Recently, Bhutan has been appointed as a chair of this forum. Earlier, India was the chair of this forum, but right now, India has handed over the chairmanship to the Bhutan. So let's read out about this news more, because this forum is an important forum. Recently, the 11th annual meeting of this forum took place virtually and it was inaugurated by Sushil Chandra, which is the India's chief election commissioner. So he was the chairman of this forum and he basically handed over the chairmanship to the Bhutan's chief election commissioner, who is Dasho Sonam Tobge. So he is the chief election commissioner of Bhutan and he has been given the chairmanship of this forum. This 11th annual meeting took place on the theme of use of technology in elections. Okay. And a Thimphu resolution was also adopted to extend the tenure of the chairmanship of this forum for 2 years during the pandemic. So that was all. Now guys, when was this forum came into effect, or how many members are there? So this forum was established in 2012 by the SAARC nations. South Asian body hai. This is a South Asian body. So all these SAARC members are the members of this forum, or basically they have established this forum. Your task is to name the members of SAARC in the comment section below. Next question is, which state has instituted Rajiv Gandhi Award for Excellence in IT sector? So this award will be given to companies for performing well in the IT sector. There is a specific date as well on which this award will be given annually. I will tell you that, but let's first know which state has launched this or instituted this award. Tamil Nadu, Odisha, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra are in the options, out of which Maharashtra is the right answer. Okay, and now let's know that on which date will this award be given. So it will be given on the birthday of Rajiv Gandhi, August 20. So that is all that is there for this news. And thank you so much for watching today's lecture. I hope that you enjoyed it and you prepare hard for your examination. All the best.